to God. Through which rivers flow. Oh, our Lord, forgive us our sins, accept our faith in the hereafter. Save us then from the hellfire, admit us to God. Through which rivers flow, through which rivers flow.
This program is sponsored by the Spare Charity Foundation.
Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalam ala rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Dear brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May peace and blessings of Allah be upon you all. I welcome you all to yet another episode of ours on a series of talks on the journey of the hereafter and the day of judgment, the day of resurrection, the day of reckoning, that is the last day of all. With our distinguished and honored guest, Sheikh Dr. Maan Kousa. So please join me in welcoming him. Assalamu alaikum, Dr. Kousa.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
So, Sheikh, in the previous episode, we saw and learned from you how and what will be the situation on the day of gathering when the people will be waiting, and how Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam will request Allah subhanahu wa taala for starting the judgment process. So now, coming to the accounting and reckoning process, could you please describe the general scenario in that situation?
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على خير الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. All praises be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May peace and blessings be upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As for the general scenario of reckoning al-hisab, this is summarized in one verse in Surah Al-Zumar, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وأشرقت الأرض بنور ربها ووضع الكتاب وجيء بالنبيين والشهداء. The earth will shine by the light of its Lord. The book, that is the record, will be placed, and the prophets and witnesses will be brought in. That summarizes how the court will be established. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the judge. The angels will come in rows. وَجَاءَ رَبُّكَ وَالْمَلَكُ صَفًّا صَفًّا. They will come in rows, having with them the records, all the things they have recorded about what people have done. So this is sort of the evidences. The prophets will also be brought in as witnesses for or against their people. And then the people will be brought in for judgment. وَعُرِضُوا عَلَىٰ رَبِّكَ صَفَّ. In a line, they will come for judgment. It will be such a serious and fearful situation that all nations will fall on their knees. وَتَرَىٰ كُلَّ أُمَّةٍ جَاثِيَةٍ. You will see every nation falling on their knees.
So, Sheikh, during this period of reckoning, what will the people be generally asked about?
Generally, everyone will be asked about everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَوَرَبِّكَ لَنَسْأَلَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. We will ask all of them, question all of them, عَمَّا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ, about all what they were doing. So everybody will be asked about almost everything. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave us few examples. He said in one hadith that no one would move from his place on the day of gathering before he is asked 5 questions. عن عمره فيما أفناه, about his lifetime, where did he spend it? How did he spend it? وعن شبابه فيما أبلاه, about his youth period in particular. How did he spend it? How did he use it? وعن ماله, about his money, his property. من أين اكتسبه؟ Where he earned it from؟ وفيما أنفقه؟ Where did he spend it in؟ And finally, the fifth question: وماذا عمل فيما علم؟ How did he act about things he knew؟ Yet another hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said. In fact, even we read this in Surah Al-Hakum Al-Takathur, the last verse: ثم لتسألن يومئذ عن النعيم. You will be questioned on that day about the blessings that Allah gave you. And the blessings that Allah gave us are uncountable. And we'll be asked about every blessing. Were we thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Now, when we talk about blessings, people tend to think of, you know, palaces and luxurious cars. And yes, these are blessings.
But every breath is also
every
blessing.
Breath is a blessing. In fact, yes. And the Prophet ﷺ once had a sip of cold water, and he said, "This is a blessing. You know, having a sip of cold water is a na'im." So we'll be asked about the blessings of Allah. Were we thankful or not? We'll be asked about promises. Have we kept our promises? Inna al-ahda kana mas'oola. We'll be asked about our hearings, our sights, our hearts. Where did we use them in? So all of these things will be asked about.
So Sheikh, in the accounting, are there some subjects which are more serious than others?
Saying that we'll be asked about everything, of course, there are things that have priority on others. The Prophet ﷺ told us that the first thing that a believer is accounted for is the prayer. The first thing. أول ما يحاسب العبد عليه يوم القيامة الصلاة. That shows the importance of prayers. It's the first thing that one will be checked for and asked for. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to his angels, look at the obligatory prayers of that man. Now if they find it complete, that's fine. If they find it incomplete, and most of the prayers we offer are incomplete. You know, we don't offer the full khushu' and concentration in the prayer. You know, sometimes we offer it in the, you know, last time, we come late to the mosque, you know, we think about other things while we are praying. So most of our prayers we pray are incomplete. Now if they are incomplete, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to the angels, does this man has any nafil prayers, voluntary prayers? If he has any, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, okay, make up the shortcomings and the missing parts of his obligatory prayers from his voluntary prayers. Then the Prophet ﷺ said in conclusion, if that man passes the prayer test, then everything next will be easy. And if he fails there, then things would be tough and difficult for him.
Sheikh, recalling from our previous episodes where we learned that different people will be treated differently during their death in their graves and how they will be resurrected, and at the same time, their situation and scenario at the time of when they're waiting for the gathering. So when the questioning comes, the accounting and reckoning, are there different types of questioning over there as well?
Yes, indeed. The way the non-believers will be questioned is different from the way the believers will be questioned. And even among the believers, we'll find different styles of reckoning or of questions. When it comes to the non-believers, now, of course, first of all, we should remember that there will be the book, the record, which has everything. As we read in Surah Al-Kahf, وَوُضِعَ الْكِتَابِ, and the book is placed, فَتَرَ الْمُجْرِمِينَ مُشْفِقِينَ مِمَّا فِيهِ. You will see the criminals fearful of what is in the record. وَيَقُولُونَ يَا وَيْلَتَنَا مَا لِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ. What is it with this book? لا يغادر صغيرة ولا كبيرة إلا أحصاها. That it does not leave behind any small or big thing except it is recorded. So everything is recorded. The non-believers will be questioned many types of questions. But they will be asked questions to show how deviant, how disobedient they were. They will be asked a question, for example, أين شركائي الذين كنتم تزعمون? Where are my partners, the partners that you are associating to me? They will also be asked a question like, ماذا أجبتم المرسلين? What did you answer the prophets?
So, Sheikh, how will the kuffar answer to these questions?
In the first attempt, they will try to deny all of this. They will say, by Allah, we haven't taken any partners. They think that, you know, this will help them on that day, you know, denying things. So say, by Allah, we haven't have any partners. They will also deny that they have any prophets and messengers. They will say, we never had any messengers and prophets. So they will first try to, you know, deny all of this and, you know, just say we haven't have any of these.
So then how will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prove them wrong?
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then will bring witnesses to testify against them. The Prophet ﷺ explained that in details for us. He said, for example, that Nuh and his people will come. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask Nuh, did you convey the message? Nuh will say, yes, Allah, I did. Then his people will be asked, have this man conveyed the message to you? They will say, no, never. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to Nuh, who are your witnesses? He will say, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his nation. Then we, the nation of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, will be asked to testify in this situation. And we will testify and say, yes, we witness that Nuh alayhi salam did convey the message, because this is what we read in Quran, and Quran is the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about this nation, وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا. We made you a just nation. لِتَكُونُوا شُهَدَاءَ عَلَى النَّاسِ. So you become witnesses on all mankind.
So then, Shaykh, how will the kuffar react to our witnessing?
The kuffar will say, you know, that we don't accept such witnesses. We need witnesses from among ourselves. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make their mouths to shut. He will seal their mouths and let their parts speak. This is what we read in Surah Yasin. الْيَوْمَ نَخْتِمُ عَلَىٰ أَفْوَاهِهِمْ. Today we will seal their mouths. وَتُكَلِّمُنَا أَيْدِيهِمْ. And their hands will speak to us. وَتَشْهَدُ أَرْجُلُهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. And their legs will testify against what they were doing. We also read in Surah Fussilat that the enemies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment will have their sights and their hearings and their skins testify against them. They will say to their skins, why do you testify against us? The skins will reply, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who made everything to speak up, made us to speak. And then the kuffar would say, you know, cursing, you know, their parts by saying, we were defending you. You know, we were defending you. And now you are testifying against us. But it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who made their parts to speak up.
Sheikh, I would like to ask you if, can someone take the burden and sins of somebody else?
Absolutely not. In fact, one of the, you know, rules of reckoning is, وَلَا تَزِرُ وَازِرَةٌ وِزْرَ أُخْرَى. No soul will take the burden of any other soul. Though, by the way, the non-believers will, in their efforts to misguide people, they will tell them, you follow us, and don't worry, if there are any sins, any consequences, we'll carry them for you. As we read in the Quran, وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. The non-believers say to the believers, اتَّبِعُوا سَبِيلَنَا. Follow our path, وَلْنَحْمِلْ خَطَايَاكُمْ. We will carry your sins. And Allah says, they are lying. They cannot carry their sins. However, these leaders will carry their own sins, and some extra sins because of their misguiding people. So they will have double sins because they are misguided and they are putting effort to misguide people. But by being double sinned, it doesn't take as at all the burden or the sins from their followers. So every soul will be accounted for what it did.
Jazakallah, Sheikh. That's all we had for this episode.
وإياكم إن شاء الله. جزاكم الله خيرا. Probably, maybe in the next episode we can elaborate on the way the non-believers,
the believers will be questioned
or questions and so on, inshallah.
Inshallah. So dear brothers and sisters, here was Sheikh Dr. Maan Kousa with us talking about the Day of Reckoning and how the Kuffar will be facing the reckoning and the questioning. Inshallah, in our next episode, we'll be discussing and learning from the Sheikh how the believers will be facing reckoning and questioning and the various kinds of believers, etc. So please don't forget to join us in the next episode. Wa akhir da'wana an alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
This program is sponsored by the SPI Charity Foundation.
Through which rivers flow, oh our Lord, forgive us our sins, accept our faith in the hereafter. Save us there from the hellfire. Admit us to God through which rivers flow, through which rivers flow.